One thing that's important as we talk about this idea of objects is that sometimes we need the user to give us some information initially so that we can set up the object correctly. All right. And so, for example, if we're trying to set up a unique identifier, like U.S. citizens have a social security number, right? And that differentiates us from other individuals. Like there are other Spencer Hiltons in the world. Have you ever Googled your own name and seen who is out there with your same name? It's creepy. But anyway, they're differentiated with a unique number that they have that differentiates them when they go in for an application or something where they need to fill out their name. They also have you put down your social security number if it's anything government related, right? Or like when you're getting a loan or something like that. And that differentiates you and your credit and everything else from the other person with your same name or other many people with your same name, right? And so if I'm going to create a program that's going to keep track of people in the U.S., and I call this public class citizen, then when I create a citizen object, I need you to tell me who that unique citizen is, or to create a social security number if they don't have one, right? Every person that's created needs to have a social security number in the U.S., right? And so I need them to give me that social security number when the object's created. We do this by using something called a constructor, and a constructor is a special method. It's going to need to be a public method that doesn't return anything. So this one is the one exception where we don't put void in here. It can't return anything, and so we don't put anything. And then it needs to be named exactly the same as the class. Okay, this method is a special method that will be called when that class is called. Now, we can't return anything, but we can receive stuff. And so in this case, I need a social security number. Well, what type of information is that? Well, it's a string, right? Because it's got hyphens in it. You can't do that in a number. I guess I could strip out the hyphens and store it as a number. But I'll read it in as a string. And I'll just call it S for now. Okay? And that'll be my method. That's my entire method. Whoops. Okay, well then I need a variable to hold it long term that I'll declare at the class level, so it'll stay in memory as long as the object is in memory, again with this idea of scope in mind. And it's going to be a string, and the string is going to be SSN. Okay, and I'll just set that equal to blank to begin with. So then when somebody creates an instance of the citizen object, it's going to require that they pass in a string, and I can then take that string. So this SSN is equal to the S that they just passed in. So I'm going to set this object's social security number equal to whatever they passed in when they created it. And so just to test this out, I'll go ahead and save this object or this class, and then I'll create a second class called public class, I don't know what, public class nation. This is the name of the nation. This is to keep track of the nation. This is all the government spying that's going on. This is the spy program. Okay, so then we have public, this is going to be the driver class, public static void main string arg. So I'm creating this program to spy on citizens. And when I create an instance of a citizen now, this is going to be a little bit different, because I can say C1 or give it whatever name I want to and set it equal to a new citizen. But notice, if I do this as is, so I'll save this, my spy program, it's going to say, sorry, the constructor in the citizen object you're trying to create cannot be applied to the given types blank. I was expecting a string, and when I found no arguments. I didn't pass anything in, and so it won't allow me to create an instance of the object because now it's mandating that I pass in a social security number. So now I can go in and say 111-222-3333, right? Is that how those go? Trying to think of my social security number. I can't think of it. That's just sad. Anyway, so now when I try to compile this, it'll compile just fine. And when it creates an instance of that object, it will have that social security number as part of the object because that's the way I declared it in the constructor. It had to have a string passed in when I declared it. Now, by the way, you don't have to pass anything in to the constructor unless you need it to. But you can have a constructor. Now again, constructor is just this special method that's called one time when the object's created for the first time. So if I have other stuff that I want to set up, if I want to, you know, initialize some information or that type of thing, I can do that in this method. Anything that would be considered setup would go in this constructor method because it's only done once. It's very convenient, and then it will never be done again. And the other thing is I can pass in no things, I can pass in one thing, or I could pass in 10 things. It doesn't matter. But if I require 10 things, then the user is going to have to pass in all 10 of those things in order for that object to be created, right? And now it starts to make a little more sense, hopefully. When we go into our regular programs, what we've been doing, when we say scanner in equals new scanner, and then we pass it system.in, the scanner object requires that you pass in what the scanner is being attached to. We can attach the scanner to the system in, but we can also attach the scanner to a file and then read in from that file. And so that's how it's been set up, right? Where other objects, like when we create a random, when we say random r equals new random, nothing in parentheses, random doesn't require that we pass anything in when we create it. It's blank. It doesn't have a constructor, or if it does, it's optional. And, you know, we can talk more about that. But sometimes, like with the scanner, we're required to pass information in when we build it, and that's because they've set it up with a constructor that requires us to do so. So that in this case, when we create an instance of a citizen, we have to pass it a string in order to set it up. That's the requirement because it's a constructor. So again, reviewing, to create a constructor, we've got the object that we're creating, and then we say when this is created, then we're going to create a special method, public. And you don't even need to put the public because that's default. You could just say citizen, but normally we'd say public. Citizen is the name of the method, and it's, again, a little bit different because it's named with a capital letter to begin with, but that's because that's the name of the class. It has to be exactly the same, matching. And then any parameters that we want to come in, and then in there we put what we want it to do, and it will only be done that first time when the object's created. Okay, so that's a constructor. When we talk about constructors, that's the constructor of an object. Excellent. Spencer out.